a local sheriff at the center of a controversial 911 call.
Four, four,
four.
Get me help, okay?
I don't need help.
The dramatic details we've uncovered about what may have caused him to collapse.
Good evening, I'm John Bach.
And I'm Monica Pearson. The Forsyth County woman called 911 in January after she found Sheriff Ted Paxton passed out in her home with her baby inside. Investigative reporter Aaron Diamond is live and coming after working for weeks to get to the bottom of just what happened. Aaron.
Yeah, Monica, that 911 call, no secret here in Forsyth County. We actually got tipped off to it a couple of weeks ago, but we held off reporting anything until we started getting some responses to our open records request. Well, after reading through all of this, here's what we know for sure.
Where's your emergency?
Red flags went up right away in January when Paula Olson came home to find a man passed out in her front doorway.
So who is this? Who?
I can't tell you.
You can't tell me?
No, I can't.
Turns out the man Olson wouldn't ID was Forsyth County Sheriff Ted Paxton.
I was out and he was kissing the baby and he drank a lot.
And I'm assuming he was babysitting for you?
Yeah, and the bottles are all empty. It's like, as far as
where's the baby? Is the baby okay?
The baby's asleep. The baby's sound asleep.
Paxton came to as rescue crews rushed to the scene.
Oh, dear God.
Well, they're here to help, Ted. You're not moving.
I've just had two words to drink.
Okay. Well, they're here to help. You're scaring me.
Despite the drama, the fire department and ambulance run sheets we got through an open records request show no emergency and no patient found. And while the sheriff turned down our repeated request for an interview to clear things up, he emailed me this statement calling it a private medical matter, saying I was suffering from a blood sugar imbalance which caused the event. An internal affairs investigation by the Forsyth County Fire Department found Paxton got no special treatment, but one first responder told investigators the sheriff seemed agitated and admitted to drinking a lot, then said, go ahead and tell all the papers your sheriff is drunk. Meantime, county leaders are debating their next move.
All I can tell you is the report says what it says, and given that it's a personnel matter involving the county, I'll have to defer any further comment.
Oh, the Forsyth County manager is also now reviewing this case. Meantime, Paxton, who calls Olson a friend, is up for re-election. In a series of statements, he called all the noise over this 911 call in local blogs, local paper, even our coverage, politically motivated, an effort to ruin his reputation and derail that re-election campaign. We're going to stay on this story and keep you posted on any details. For now, we're live in Forsyth County. Aaron Diamond, Channel 2 Action News.